Good morning, warriors. Clearing some energy here. Clearing. Just burning some white sage. If you don't have any white sage, it's a very excellent tool to use along this healing journey to help clear any negative energy, any overthinking, any toxicity in your life and in your home. Go around into all the corners and just clear. Some beautiful white sage recommending there. On the topic of clearing, did I even introduce myself? I am B, but you already know that, I think, anyways. Welcome to the Unfuckening Movement. Today, I thought it would be fun, since I'm in a little bit of a lighter humor. Spirit has instructed me that we're going to do a little bit of light language, and we're going to do a little bit of clearing of overthinking. So that's why I was drawn to bring out some sage and clear some of that energy. So before I begin with a reading today to lighten things up and have a little bit of fun, I'm going to do a little bit of light language and channel some messages for us so that we can clear our mental areas. Moving the energy down into the ground. Softening. Visualize the energy moving downwards in through all the chakras. down your legs, down through the bottom of your feet, transmuting into the earth. Visualizing a violet ray of light. Violet ray is transmutation. Surrounding ourselves completely. Violet ray of light. Shielding ourselves. Brilliant white light. A ball of light. Bringing in the energy of the angelic realm. Keep us safe and protected. Sitting in this energy, just breathe. Giving thanks and gratitude. All right. Well, that was a fun way to start today's video. I'm getting more and more in confidence, bringing light language and blessings on camera. It's been a work in progress for me as more and more of my intuitive gifts have come online through this spiritual awakening. Just to briefly talk about that, as you go through your spiritual awakening, do understand more gifts will come online. I read a post the other day on one of the forums that I follow about a woman who was talking about how she was having a lot of premonitions and struggling to integrate these gifts into her reality and was feeling overwhelmed. So do understand, you know, we all have a quest to open that third eye, and when that third eye opens and our crown chakra begins to open more and more, more of our intuitive knowings and more of our gifts in an extrasensory way will start to manifest. And when those manifests, be aware, it can be overwhelming, anxiety ridden, panic, you know, feeling like, I don't want this. I want to go back to my old blind reality. And you can't go back. Although I have heard of some people trying very desperately to make that happen by falling back into old paradigm habits, such as alcoholism and other addictions and distractions. When you start to reopen and come back onto line, a lot of these gifts that are given to you may not feel like gifts at first. They may feel like a double-edged sword, where on the one hand, yes, you've been handed some beautiful spiritual gift, and on the other hand, it is making you step out of the comfort zone that was your life. And that comfort zone was comfortable. That's why it's called the comfort zone. So if you are on the spiritual journey and starting to waken to new levels of empathy, new levels of all your clairs, it's okay if you take time to acclimatize, get used to. It's not something that you might want to run out into the world and go, hey, everybody, I'm telepathic. Certainly not. For a very long period of time, I was like, am I doing this? Is this real? Is this really happening? Am I having these hits? Am I picking up on information that I have no right to know, but I know it anyways? Yes, I went through a long period of time where integration of these new higher chakra gifts were attuning, and as something attunes, just like anything else. My son is a musician, and you know, when he's tuning his guitar, it's not like the first time you get it, you're like right on pitch. First, you're a little bit too high, And then you're a little bit too low and you're dong, 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 dong. And you're moving and manipulating. He plays guitar. You're moving and you're manipulating the strings so that they can vibrate at a frequency that makes a pleasant sound. So when you are in the process of awakening, understand that sometimes there's a good few months, if not more, of fine-tuning those skills that you're given. And it's okay. It's a practice. This is a spiritual practice. So today, I really wanted to just do something fun and light. I went to see a comedian last night, which put me in a much lighter spirit of mind, Ricky Gervais. He is just amazing. And his show, Armageddon, aptly titled for the stage and phase that we are at in humanity, was hilarious, if not quite rude at times, and you know, borderline inappropriate. But hey, that's, if we can't laugh at the borderline inappropriate and we take everything too seriously, we're doing ourselves a disservice and keeping our own vibrational frequency in a very low level. I do apologize. There's a dog barking in the background. Hopefully it's not too obnoxious, but we'll laugh at the folly of that too, because I guess he's got something that he'd like to add. And to those that are animal empaths, maybe you can translate his messages. I believe he's saying, I would like in the house. Let's see if somebody assists him in that. All right, here we go. I'm gonna throw some glasses on so I can actually read. And today I am starting with the Twin Flame Ascension Take Me Home Oracle deck. Well, I would like to go home to my home planet, my home dimension, that's for sure. On this journey, in acclimatizing to your spiritual gifts, you also have to acclimatize and integrate. And we got two cards here, so I'll take them both. We have to acclimatize and integrate our new levels of who and what we are, as we shed the old and step into our new selves. That too is an integration process that's going to take a little bit of time. So our first card up is 10-10 and High Priestess. Expanding consciousness, and that is very much ties into, you know, where we started this video today about opening and clearing our higher chakras, our third eye, our crown, which are both interconnected and part of understanding a new level of consciousness, a new level of awareness. You know, our consciousness for a long period of time has existed in a 3D realm of that which is, you know, the first three chakras. As we've moved up into the heart, which is very much a 4D awareness, something is bigger and greater at play, that energy of love and unconditional love, and moving up into 5D awarenesses into our higher level of consciousness. So the High Priestess always calls upon energies of the higher realms. And it doesn't matter if you're male or female. We all have divine masculine and divine feminine within us. And we all have the capacity to connect to that higher source energy. You can see in this card, she has a sparkle of light just above her crown. She's sitting in a meditative pose. And she has the Ankh, which is above her head, which is actually a vibrational, musical, spiritual symbol that was used in the time of Egyptians in the pyramids, which were healing centers, vibrational healing centers, sound healing. So if you are drawn to connect to your higher source and open that third eye and open your crown chakras even more, connect in to vibrational frequency, frequency through solfeggio frequencies, sound bowls and sound baths are an excellent way. You know, maybe invest in, you can get a Tibetan sound bowl for quite inexpensive. You can get a very expensive for each of the chakras sound bowls made out of crystal quartz that produce amazing sounds. If you don't want to produce the sounds yourself, go on Spotify or YouTube and or look in your community for some sound healing, vibrational free healing, and that's an excellent way to connect and be able to ground yourself into a meditative state, either while you're in a sitting position or, as I personally recommend, getting out and doing your aligned walking as a form of meditation, a movement meditation, especially if you are on the spectrum, have ADD or any degree of autism, Asperger's, OCD, any of these types of things. Movement is very much required for those that are on the energy of the spectrum of light, because it's through movement our whole body is in a vibrational state at that point when we're in movement. Which you will find will greatly assist you if you struggle with the traditional Zen meditation, where you're just sitting in, you know, a position. Even in my yoga practice, as I'm trying to ground more things, I allow for micro movements. So as you come home from your aligned walking and you want to counterbalance that energy, you've just established some yang energy with action, you want to counterbalance that with some yin exercises. If you don't do yin yoga, you can learn some yin yoga from Yoga with Cassandra on YouTube. She's incredible. Or otherwise, just do basic yoga where you're on the ground, let gravity work for you. That's connecting to Mother Earth energy. And, you know, lie on your back, legs up. Perhaps I've been guided that I will be doing another yin style or ground floor exercise stretching style video for those that are looking for some techniques. Now, I'm not a yogini, however, I have been using yin throughout this process, and it's something that I want to share with people, because incorporating even micro movements allows the muscle to relax even more. So if you're in whatever position you're in and you just allow through the breath, just a micro movement while you're holding any position, you might find it really boosts your yoga practice, is just allowing slight movement, especially along the spine, because the more we get our spine into a state of fluidity, like a bicycle chain that each little knob moves, and you don't have certain ones that are like locked down and frozen. So establishing just a little bit of movement while you're holding your positions might be something that benefits you. Always do things very gently, very slowly, and very carefully. All of these types of things are going to help us connect to our higher priestess. So let's look at 10-10. And the card in the book, High Priestess, Expanding Consciousness. When the High Priestess makes an appearance, it is a sign that you are elevating into higher dimensions of awareness. You are open, ready, and willing to embrace the divine presence as you align with pure love and light. You trust your heart and you experience oneness with the universal consciousness because you have mastered the ability to reconnect with your source energy found within. You are experiencing life after death and creating a new identity. This clean slate affords you the opportunity to create endless possibilities. Choose to let go of any remaining limitations and open yourself to the idea of infinite abundance. Trusting yourself helps you make solid decisions that align with your strong intuition. This elevated consciousness enhances your ability to embody your greatest potential because you stand up for your truth. You are viewing things from a higher perspective. This heightened awareness shifts your limiting beliefs beyond your perceived illusions as you rise up to your highest creative capabilities, allowing you to create a more fulfilling life. Excellent. Love all the messages in there. And our second card that I pulled out is one that we've had before, which is the card 7-7 and mystical messages. And I love this card because I posted a video yesterday called Who the Fuck I Am or something along those lines. And I love this card because you can see the third eye right in the center of this, and then the sacred geometry that spins around it. And as I was thinking about the question of who am I, more and more the reality and the awareness that I am a multi-dimensional being. If you think of yourself as a crystal, there's many faces on a crystal that a crystal holds, and each of those may seem sometimes counterintuitive to the other. For example, I'm a spiritual person, but I'm also like a comedian that can say and laugh at wild inappropriate jokes. You know, those may seem at odds with each other, but they are both faces of the same crystal. And this sacred geometry that circles around this triangular third eye, this pyramid of self, of I am, and that's the absolute highest level of consciousness, is the understanding that I am. That's the end of the sentence, because you are everything and you are nothing. You are the Alpha and the Omega. And I am, that's your mission for today. So I would like you to, as a warrior, really connect with the energy of what you are. Through the awakening journey, we've gone through a lot of shedding of what we are not. So now the quest is determining what you are. So put on this top of a page, I am, and then just list as many words as you can come up with to describe who and what you are. Use adjectives, use verbs, use nouns, it doesn't matter. I am mother, I am actress, I am a spiritual teacher, I am a student, I am a quirky person, I am a starseed, I am a twin flame, I am a, what are all the I ams? Help to identify yourself as that multidimensional being by getting to know yourself through the light. Shadow work is all about getting to know through the things yourself, through the things that are hidden in the dark that you may have repressed. So you need to look at both sides of this, and not just the light of all the good things that you are. Also embrace all the things that you've kept hidden. For me, for many years, I kept certain truths about myself very hidden, especially when it came to my gifts. I didn't want to have those gifts because I wanted to be perceived as normal. And I am normal is not on my list. I have accepted, and self-acceptance is the ultimate quest of this healing journey of learning to love self. L is for loving self, and loving self means accepting self for all the faces that you are, not just the faces that you want to show the world of I am smart, and I am funny, or I am cute, I am whatever that we want to show the world in our Instagram videos. Show the world the things that you have been hiding and keeping in shadow as well, because when you are truly in balance, you can be whole again. Instead of being fragmented version of your whole self, you are a whole self, and you are imperfect, multidimensional, deserving of love, deserving of value for all that you are, not just showing up into the world presenting normality or showing perfection or showing being in control. let it all hang out, so to speak, and step into who you truly are. That's the message of this card today. And then I'm going to go into another book that I deck that I treated myself to after I had a very strong meditative moment as I was receiving massage. I was loving self enough to treat myself to and treat my body to what it needs, and the more I work on my body and the more I heal my body and the more I love my body and love my mind, the more open I become to guidance. And one of the things that I was guided in was the energy of dragons. And that's not something that I've in the past, you know, well, that's not really my thing, but maybe it is, because I'm embracing now all the aspects of myself, and I definitely have a fiery side to self as a Sagittarius, and have at times in my life burned the city down. Just like if you've watched the Game of Thrones, a lot of people complained about the last season. I empathized with her, Khaleesi. I understood her frustration and her angst and her desire to burn it all to the ground. And sometimes in our healing journey, that's exactly what we do. We have lived our life in a tower waiting for some prince to come on, ride along. And perhaps what we need to step into is the reality that we are all the faces in the storyline. We are the damsel in distress. We are the hero on the horse, and we are the dragon. And sometimes you need to burn some shit down to the ground so that you can transform and be more like the phoenix rising up out of the flames and create a new and beautiful life for yourself, which is what the High Priestess card was telling us is in our future, is building and creating, manifesting a life full of abundance. But to get that life, sometimes you need to burn shit down. So, and our card that I pulled today is the card of loss. And we all know that as we are on this healing journey at this stage, that we will experience a lot of loss. Loss of self, loss of partners, loss of friends, loss of family members for a period of time sometimes. Sometimes they come back in. Loss of our identity, loss of our desires to participate in old things that we used to keep us comforted and soothed and, you know, synthetically is how I describe addictions, is synthetic soothing instead of being able to genuinely soothe ourselves. And so this dragon here is flying high above, not in an angry state, but high above and protecting almost this angel of the unicorn. And, you know, unicorns are a magical energy. Again, not one that I would have in my old version of self resonated too much with, but the more I step in to my spiritual self, the more I open myself to the teachings of sources that I wouldn't have normally looked at, which includes, you know, the animal kingdom and the elemental kingdom of fairies and sprites and unicorns, dragons. All my understanding of all of these things are physical, illustrative, how's the best way to say this? Illustrative examples of energy that we can't really explain any other way than through imagery and metaphor. It's when we get too literal, and I have in my past been sometimes too literal in my understanding of things. As we open ourselves and open our consciousness, we can become aware that a lot of the things that exist in the world out there are metaphorical in nature. And the metaphor of the unicorn is very much about originality and uniqueness and, you know, rarity. clarity. And within each of us has that sparkle of light. This unicorn here's horn is glowing as a light worker, leading it in a direction as it's all alone, you know, aside from the dragon that's protecting it. This unicorn is alone, as you often see unicorns depicted alone. You know, the movie The Last Unicorn and other movies, you don't usually see a herd of unicorns. And so that's a message in itself, that on the healing journey, embracing that energy of uniqueness, of originality, of rarity, and understanding that you're not going to resonate with everyone around you, especially while you're going through the healing journey. You are meant, the whole point of it is to go within, as our High Priestess talked us, so that you can discover your I am, the truth of who you are, because the truth of who you are is truly unique, and that uniqueness needs to be embraced and protected. Protect yourself from sources that are going to like minimize, put down, you know. And the dragon in this energy, it's friendly towards the unicorn. It's very much, I'm gonna protect you. It's not looking at the unicorn like, I'm gonna eat you. So if you have a dragon energy around you that looks like it's gonna eat you, get the fuck away from that, and find a dragon energy that you can work with you and protect your uniqueness. So loss, I'm gonna go and read the card for loss today. This is a brand new deck, and we'll see what the author Christine Arana Fader has to say about loss. You are a dragon rider, a warrior of light. Well, you certainly are if you're here on the Unfuckening Movement and watching my videos and doing the work and showing the way. You have been placed here on Earth to fight for a better world. A way shower. We, the light-filled warriors of Lady Gaia and the beings that live on Earth, love this world. We stand up for love and light because they are wonderful, and yet they could be lost. Deep within us, we have the knowledge that we are ready to connect once again with the power of the dragons and unicorns. It is in our nature to protect and preserve. Be aware that our Earth is a paradise to be reconquered with your help. Focus on what is valuable, on what could be lost, on love, on wonderful and divine creation, and on the natural world here on Earth. Do whatever is in your power to protect nature, including your own natural environment. We are who we are only because we have something to lose. We warriors of the light, dragon riders, unicorn souls, sorcerers and priestesses. Our belief is our sword. Our love is our shield. We are the guardians of this world. Call on your dragon and join it with entertaining the service of love. That is beautiful. Very much so on my healing journey myself. I have understood that my purpose more and more is to come to the world and share my messages as a service of love, to be in the service of the divine, so that I can assist others in getting out of the dark, because I'm very familiar with the dark, and I have very much felt like an oddity, a weirdo, a freak throughout much of my life, and because I denied and repressed who I was. So in learning to love self, I have learned to be able to come back and show the way, use that light from within to assist others on their healing path. So that's a beautiful card. And we're going to move now into my last deck, which for the day is the Archeo and understanding and developing your archetypes. Our archetypes very much can be depicted as the faces that we wear out in the world, or the energies that we carry with us. I've talked about archetypes in a lot of my videos because I think they're very powerful teachers, and that one wants to be our card. Oh, interesting. Starclimber. I'm loving this. It's again kind of a snake-like dragon-y thing because it's a snake with ears. Never seen that snake with ears before. So this snake is climbing the ladder, and that it reminds me, it's actually very funny because often I have felt like on this spiritual awakening, this kundalini awakening or twin flame journey, that it's been like that game snakes and ladders, and you know, I'm getting up a certain distance and then I'll get a boost and yay, look, something happened, and then I go another little bit of distance and then I hit a snake and it's like right back down to where I started from. I'm like, are you kidding me? No. And you know, a good few times I've got to what felt like the end of the board, and then you hit that super long snake and you're like right back down near the beginning, and I'm like down on my hands and knees pleading and praying, not again, no. But the whole point of snakes and ladders is to learn cycles, for one, and is to repeat patterns, because only through repetition do you understand that new neural pathways can be laid. You can't just all of a sudden, yay, I'm at the end, and think that the healing journey is going to be a straight line. It's a spiral. That's how healing works, is moving up in a spiral. And there's the element of chance and the element of the unknown. As we roll the dice, you know, we on from day to day, from move to move, we never know what the universe is going to help propel us or going to slow us down. Maybe for a stretch, we're rolling ones, snake eyes. And we're like, really? Come on, come on. Can I go faster? I want to go faster. I want to go faster. And the universe is like, slow down. You need to go through this section of the game of life a little bit slower so that you can learn patience, perhaps. Or then the next roll, you're getting like, I can't recall if there was two dice or just a single solitary dice, but maybe you're getting like double sixes. Woo! And, you know, you get to move on up in a really fast spurt. So sometimes life is very much a lesson of learning to, one, accept and surrender that you're not in control of how many moves you get to make in what order, and you're not in control of your destiny when you land on a snake and are brought back down to repeat a lesson that you've already learned. But ultimately, we are ascending. The point of the game is, the point of the game is to keep on moving and to keep on trying and to keep on at it. It's a practice so that we can ascend up into the stars, up into enlightenment. Up, up, up is where we want to go. Interestingly, I'm just going to note here that the initials that are on this card is an L and a K. So I don't know if those initials mean anything to you. And we have a little sun in a box down at the corner. So those are just some extra symbols that we're getting. And the star that we're at is a five-pointed star. So those may have some meanings for you out there. And let's go into Starclimber. The attribute of the Starclimber. The Starclimber places a ladder against the night sky and begins his ascent into the heavens. His intention is to reach beyond the mortal limits of gravity and explore the infinite possibilities of human consciousness. As he ascends, he looks down on everything below and is rewarded with an understanding of his purpose. So the more we get into a higher self and observing the world through higher self and connecting to soul and connecting to spirit, we understand the cyclical patterns of our life, and things stand out, and we get more and more ahas. And ahas are brilliant once you get there. It's getting to them sometimes that seems arduous and a steady, difficult climb. the persona of the star climber. He's climbing towards a particular star, a beacon in the heavens that's forever moving yet always fixed. The further the star climber travels, the more alone he becomes. But for him, isolation is a small price to pay for the reward. Once aloft, the sense of replenishment and restoration are too profound to ignore. He has exchanged the mundane for a journey into the mystic, and he is content with his choice. To others, seen from the ground, it may appear that he is engaged in some metaphysical game of snakes and ladders, or wallowing in New Age crystal gazing. But the star climber's ascent is far from indulgent. His ambitions are far higher. He is seeking a form of spiritual astronomy, a means of looking into the heart of the cosmos in order to construct a list of questions that, if answered, would reveal the nature of his being. So ultimately, it's the quest of self. You are the star in this story. You are the climber. You are also the ladder, and you are also the star. So you are the one that gets in your own way. You are the one that propels yourself in action and movement. A is for achieving, and you are ultimately seeking self. You are ultimately learning to discover yourself, your shiny nature, your truth, your aspect in all that you are, all the I ams. So the more you utilize all of these lessons along the path, from the high spirit priestess, and even if that is crystal gazing and it looks odd for other people, this crystal here is some apatite. I love this one here. We've got some citrine today, and I have some rose quartz, always good for the heart chakra, rose quartz, and citrine, particularly good for your solar plexus, for that action oriented energy. And apatite is a great stone here for the throat chakra, for helping be more in your authenticity, in your truth, because the truth of the matter is you are a warrior, and the truth of the matter is you are a light worker, and the truth of the matter is you are a way shower, and the truth of the matter is you are a multifaceted star. And just like this crystal here that has many, many faces on it, you too have many, many faces and angelic energy infused within you, stardust infused within you, the cosmos infused within you. So that said, go ascend on your path as the spiritual warrior that you are, and keep climbing. Even when you're having the setbacks, even when you're experiencing losses, protect yourself and protect your energy, and keep moving forward, even though it may feel like a sharp climb at times. That said, have a super fucking awesome day, and go unfuck some shit. Peace out.